Ahoy, this is Zdenka. Should I get an actual camera or should it be good enough to record with a smartphone? Is it gonna be good enough for YouTube? Do I need to buy a gimbal? What gimbal is the best? Do I need to buy lenses? What is the best microphone? Can I mix the footage from smartphone and drone and other action cameras? How am I gonna make the footage look the same? How do you actually work with that? Can I make money with smartphone through my videos and photos? Do stock agencies actually accept smartphone photos and videos? And if so, where can I sell them? And yeah, what is the best video editing app or video editing software? All these questions pop up below the videos on this channel quite frequently. So in today's video, let's talk about 8 things you should know or should think about, consider before you get into smartphone filmmaking. This video is sponsored by Zyro. The audience on this channel, you, is made of people who record for fun, their families, their kids, their pets, their vacations, their travel. Then there are real estate agents who record their properties for sale. Then there are small business owners who record their products or services for their social media, a YouTube channel, websites. And there are some of you, some of the people who are dreaming about producing a short film or even full-length feature film. You guys are all over the place. I use smartphone. And I also use a regular camera. Smartphone I use for social media. I use it for the family stuff. And I use it sometimes for my professional stuff. Now, from my personal experience, this is how I see it. If you are deciding to strictly go with a smartphone or investing into a camera, investing. Smartphone is budget-friendly option, very convenient. You don't need big equipment. It's always around you. But I find that the production time is a little bit more time consuming to get the final video. You can also get easily overwhelmed with all the settings and all the apps, all these options. You have to be very careful with the settings so you don't accidentally change them. When I record with a regular camera, it's just very simple. There's nothing to be overwhelmed with. There's always the same settings. You just turn it on, you record, it doesn't change on you, and you just edit and publish. But there is the cost. You have to get extra lenses. You might have to get even a gimbal. Then it becomes this very bulky thing, and you will get a lot of expensive equipment. So you need to consider those both sides. In this video, we are going with the convenient option, the budget-friendly option, and that would be smartphone. The most important decision you have to make is what smartphone you are going to choose, the base. If you are someone who just wants to film in automatic mode, who doesn't care about the filters and all that, and manual mode, then it doesn't really matter what smartphone you have. You will just use whatever is in your pocket. If you are someone like me who loves to film in manual mode, wants to use variable anti-filter and lenses and different apps and all that, then you might actually want to be a little bit more selective. Otherwise, you will end up sometimes a bit frustrated. I used to be exclusively Android user before I switched to iPhone. I was filming with Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. What made me switch to Apple were mainly the compatibility issues. What you didn't see when I was filming the tutorials with Android phone was that majority of the third-party apps sometimes were crashing on me and they were freezing. The footage sometimes turned out to be very jumpy, very skippy, and people commented on those videos. And it was very time-consuming, at times very stressful. So I was literally forced to switch to Apple. Once I did that, there were no more issues. Everything was working perfectly. All the gimbals were compatible. I had no issues from there on, and I could continue to produce these videos on this channel. Now, when I'm making all these tutorials, primarily those cinematic B-roll tutorials, they apply for any smartphone. So it doesn't matter if you have a Google Pixel, or if you have Samsung, or if you have iPhone. I'm still very much a fan of Android, and I do prefer Android, but for my job, it is way easier to use iPhone. Do you need to buy a gimbal? Quite recently, I published a video handheld filming in Filmmake Pro. The whole thing was filmed handheld and the stabilization was excellent. Well, there are situations where you definitely need other tools. For example, sit-down interviews. You're going to use a tripod because you cannot use gimbal. The gimbal has motors and they are working constantly, so each gimbal has a draft. Over the period of time, the frame is going to shift a little bit. Gimbal is to help you when you need to film in motion. When I was filming handheld video in nature, I had to be careful with my horizon level, something I certainly wouldn't have to worry about if I was using a gimbal. The gimbal keeps the horizon level perfect for you at all time. So I found a challenge there. I was also limited with the long moving forward or sideways moves. Again, it was quite tricky to keep the horizon level and try to walk as stable as I could. Gimbals will also give you other features and programmed moves which you simply cannot recreate with handheld moves. Just to name a few, tracking, motion lapses, spin shot. Filming with gimbal and handheld would be a perfect mix. A question I get at least once a week is this: what gimbal is the best? What gimbal do you recommend me to buy? There is no one particular gimbal fits all. You need to be able to answer all these questions. What are you going to be filming? Are you going to be filming only in automatic mode? Do you want to film in manual mode? Are you going to attach filters or lenses? Do you need just something basic for social media, or do you need something able to hold more weight? Do you have Android or iPhone? Where are the lenses located? Are they at the edge of the phone or in the middle? Do you need inception mode? What is your budget? Do you see where I'm going with this? There are different kinds of gimbals on the market for a reason. Whenever I'm making a gimbal review, I go all in depth and I show all the features so you can make a decision if all the features you are looking for are indeed there. Whenever I read a comment when someone says, oh, this gimbal is a garbage, I already know that there's nothing wrong with the gimbal because I have them all here and I tested them all. Very simply put, the person made a wrong choice of a product for him or her, or doesn't know how to use it properly yet. By the way, I will be making a huge comparison video very soon where I'll compare all the gimbals for 2022. So make sure you're subscribed if you're not already. Can you make money with smartphone footage? If you are a real estate agent and you are using your smartphone to capture the properties for sale, or if you are a small business owner who is capturing the products or services for sale, then you are already making money with your smartphone. If you are a creator or YouTuber, becoming a YouTuber, then you might be thinking if smartphone will be able to generate you extra income. My answer is that yes, it is enough. It can generate you extra income. If you take some really nice photos, high quality photos, you can sell small prints. They don't have to be large. Even small prints will do. If you have a lot of great footage on your smartphone, you can actually sell them on stock. And that's what I do. I used to upload stock footage and photos to stock agencies separately, but I don't have time to do that anymore. So I chose to go with Wirestock. I simply just dump all the footage on there and they do all the keyboarding and everything distribution for me. I don't have to do anything. I have to share the revenue with them though. I am making definitely less than I would be making if I would do everything myself and upload it to the agencies separately. But again, I don't have the time. So instead of just having the smartphone footage sitting on my hard drive, not making any money, at least I am making some money. I'm finding that I get better chance for photos being accepted from a smartphone if I take photos photojournalistic style, or photos which are taken in ideal lighting conditions so there are no technical issues, because stock agencies are quite picky about that. When it comes to video, I don't see any issues there. I typically have all the videos accepted, no problem. I mentioned that you can sell prints. That is a reason why I switched my entire website to Zyro 3 months ago. And Zyro is a sponsor of today's video. When you want to sell any products on your website, they also have the option to enable selling your products on social media such as Facebook and Instagram. You can also sell on Amazon. They have that integration. Another reason is the fact that it is the most affordable option on the market and it's very simple to use, just drag and drop style. There are hundreds of pre-designed templates to choose from. You can create your own if you prefer. If you need help with anything, yes, they have 24/7 customer service and you are actually going to be talking to a person. And I know because I needed help with something and I tried the customer service and I got straight to the point answers very quickly. What is important for me, for example, is the fact that the website is loading fast. You can create a blog and customize SEO, which makes you being found in search engines. Also, Zdenka website plans have a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you change your mind, you cancel the subscription, you will get your money back. Click the link below or use my code Zdenka to get Zdenka's limited time deal. Get an exclusive discount plus a custom domain and 3 months free with any yearly plan. Thank you very much, Zdenka, for making this video possible. In a past video, I was mixing smartphone footage with the drone footage from DJI Mini 2 and Insta360 ONE X2 camera. Many of you asked me how I make the footage look the same for all. Some of you might be thinking about using different types of cameras together. I mix even Canon with Sony footage a lot in a lot of my videos, and I don't think that people even realize that because so far nobody said anything. It all starts with selecting the same white balance in all cameras I'm going to be using. That is a good start. The rest is all done when I'm editing the video. I personally edit in Adobe Premiere Pro. What I do first is pull out a clip from my smartphone and let's say drone. I use an automatic white balance selector to try to get the white balance as similar as possible. Once that is done, if I need to adjust the white balance further, I simply just use the sliders. Once that is done, then I usually play with blue colors and greens to match them up. Once I see that I got the same look with both, I save the LUTs. And yes, sometimes I have to color correct individual clips to make sure they're all in sync. Another question which always pops up below the videos is, what microphone is the best for a smartphone? And very similarly, just like with the gimbals, there is no one microphone type of fits all. Smartphones have already pretty good microphones built in. If you want better sound, you can use a plug-in microphone. You can use this right angle cable so you can have it on the gimbal. I personally prefer lavalier as it is better on a windy day. You can walk away from the camera and still be heard. You can either connect the receiver to your smartphone or you don't have to connect anything at all. If you have this type of lavalier, as this one has a built-in memory card, you can record the sound separately and then sync the sound in the post. I explained that in the last Wondershare firmware tutorial. If you want something high-tech, but unfortunately it comes also with a high price tag, you might consider Smart Mic Plus Bluetooth microphone. They advertise that if you buy their combo package with two microphones, you can use it with any third-party app. I don't have that one, so I cannot test it with gimbal's apps, but I was told many times that it would be a good solution. What is the best video editing app or software to use? You might think about it before you get into smartphone filmmaking as well. What would be the best way to edit on what you are planning to do with the videos? And this is something I wanted to address, and I feel I have to address this. So I've been editing for some time, for a couple of years, in Adobe Premiere Pro because I have a very strong computer and I also pay for the whole Adobe bundle. I use also Photoshop and Lightroom. Now, a couple months ago, I posted a video which was a complete tutorial or complete walkthrough of Wondershare Filmora. I was quite surprised to receive few comments which were highly inappropriate, very angry tone, calling me names, that I posted a tutorial on this software instead of DaVinci Resolve. Here is my answer. First of all, I will be creating very soon tutorials on KineMaster, LumaFusion, Adobe Rush, even DaVinci Resolve and others. This channel is never going to be only about one software, one camera, one gimbal, one brand, or one price category. Let's be very open-minded and very realistic. There are several categories of people. Some people are able to afford a very strong computer which can handle DaVinci Resolve and Adobe Premiere Pro, for example. In our family, we have four different computers. Only one computer can run those programs, and that will be only my computer. And then there are people who have those basic computers. They cannot afford high-end computers. People who don't want to learn complicated programs and they want something very simple. Those people use smartphones for filming, not something like Sony a7S III. For that category, Wondershare Filmora would be a good option. For the rest of my family, that software would be also a very good option. And lastly, there is a group of people who simply want to edit on their smartphones only. LumaFusion, KineMaster, Adobe Rush would be some of the apps to use. Once you learn how to edit in one app, you can edit in all because they are pretty much the same, all of them. I cannot tell you which one software is the best. You have to really think about your situation. If you have a capable hardware, if you have a strong computer, or if you just want to edit on the go, on a smartphone, it really depends on your situation. I prefer editing on a computer because I'm finding that on smartphone it's just way too small for me. I get better workflow on a computer and I can edit very precisely there. And if you prefer editing directly on the smartphone, you can start with any free basic app. And then once you outgrow it and you feel that you need more features, you can move on depending on what you can afford to purchase. And again, this is why I make all these in-depth walkthroughs, those tutorials. So you can look at it and you can make a decision which one actually is suitable for you. It was a bit of a chat today. Hopefully you got some answers or something to think about. Give it a thumbs up if you want to. If you have any questions, want to say hi or ahoy, please leave it below. And I'll see you in the next video. Ciao. Ahoy.